Hello, everybody. I'm Leora Sims. Welcome to my channel, and welcome to part 3 of my Sims 4 Cats and Dogs Let's Play. As you can probably tell, my Sim Belle here is about to be sick. This is Belheim. And she lives in her home with her husband, Jonathan, and her dog, Snow. Both Belle and Jonathan started off as teens. You may be wondering why the scene you just saw was so short. And that is because it's the second time that I'm recording this episode. After Belle had morning sickness, the first time I recorded this, I clicked on Jonathan, who was walking their dog, Snow. And that changed the camera angle considerably, which bothered my eyes. So I wanted to make sure that that didn't happen a second time. Because Belle Heim and Jonathan Heim started off as teens, they have extra traits. Jonathan is a dog lover. He's cheerful. He's a quick learner. He's a vegetarian, and he's compassionate. If you watched the first episode of this Let's Play, you saw Belle and Jonathan. They visited Rosanna. Jonathan has a level 1 in charisma. He's a very shy guy. He has a level 1 in comedy, almost a level 2 though. He has a level 1 in fitness. A level 1 in gardening. And a level 2 in piano. If you have watched my channel for some time, perhaps you recognize Belheim not only from the first episode of this Let's Play, but my Create a Sim Showcase. Belle is creative, she's clumsy, she has good manners, she's a collector, she's family-oriented, she's responsible, and she is compassionate. Belle and her husband are based off of friends of mine. Let me go into Belle's relationship panel. Belle knows that Snow is an adult. He's male. He's a couch potato. He's loyal. And he's adventurous. She's friends with him, and he is a bulldog. Originally, I wanted Belle and Jonathan to start off with a different kind of dog, but last week, a friend visited me with his wife, and he showed up with not only his wife, but his new dog, which looked like a Dalmatian, to be honest with you, but it was some type of bulldog. If I were to guess, it's mixed with some bull terrier and something else. But it had a very nice temperament. What I like about Create a Pet is that if you are creating a certain type of pet, Create a Pet will generate at least one character trait for the pet. My friend told me that his dog liked to lay around with them and watch TV. And when I generated a bulldog, the trait that I saw was couch potato. The dog that my friends had that I met last week was also very loyal, and it just wanted affection, and it was fascinated by the outdoors as well. So I'm going to have Belle pet Snow. I did use some of the paints on Snow. Very little, though. What does she want to do? I don't want Belle to buy a pet bed. I want her to take him out to the yard. Because I think he probably needs to go potty. She's gonna call Snow. And she's going to wake him up. He's always sleeping because he's a couch potato.
Drishy!
She's gonna brush him. She's going to ask him to go potty now. Which was not an option a second ago. They're going to go on an adventure together.
Conozoi sleep.
I want to see what happened. Oh, he really needs a bath. Oh, no, he doesn't. Oh, they disappear. They went on an adventure. It's like doing volunteer work with your Sim family. I wasn't expecting that at all. So I'm going to have Jonathan clean this up. There's no reason why his pregnant wife do that. Oh. Adventure is out there. It's time for an adventure. Snow sniffs the air, picks up three distinct paths. Directed by sense in all directions, Snow needs some help deciding which way should Belle take them? The town square? The lighthouse? Whiskerman's Wharf? The town square? all a dog and its human need is simple, is a simple visit to the town square. Okay, Jonathan, you're going to come over here. Gonna pull back. And Jonathan is going to throw this away. And they're going to head home. Then he's going to water the plants. They have strawberries on this lot, but they also have blackberries. I named these houses for a town in Rhode Island. So I wanted to know produce that grows in Rhode Island, and it said something about blackberries, so I made sure that they had a blackberry bush. And not every one of these homes has plants. Oh, and Bella's home. So they can relax and unwind, which I think is a good idea. I think that's so cute. Another thing I learned is that it's important for your Sims to unleash their dogs if they're on the leash. I thought my game was malfunctioning because I wanted to send Jonathan home. The dog was sleeping. And I wanted the dog to wake up and Jonathan to go home. But because the dog was leased, he couldn't. And it said something like, wait for dog. Then I got him to call the dog, and they both went home together with the dog leased. And I wanted Jonathan to take a shower, and he could not take a shower until he unleashed the dog. Which I know nobody takes a shower with their dog. However, I didn't think you'd have to tell your Sims to unleash the dog. I just thought that eventually when the walk was over, the dog would be unleashed. I decided to end this episode here, and in the next episode, I will be exploring Rendolin Bay again. I hope that you enjoyed this episode as much as I enjoyed bringing it to you. Be happy, everyone.